I think you better take the machine. We can find that it uses a way to check if something happens and does some action. And chooses one of two possible actions to perform. That is the conditional statement, which is also called the if statement because of the keyword that is used for it. In insert money, there is this kind of conditional statement. Which checks if the amount that is inserted is positive. The conditional statement is also used in everyday life. For example, if I have enough money, I will go out for a meal. Otherwise, I will stay to watch a movie. So there are two possible actions, and the one to perform is chosen by a check or a test in the conditional statement. The check is present after the if in the brackets, and in this case, it uses the greater than operator to compare the amount with the compared the amount with it being a positive or a negative value. And only one of the two possibilities will then be performed, only the error message or only the increase of the balance, depending on the result of this test, which is a boolean is a value that can only be is a value that, and a boolean can only have one of two possible values, which are true and false. So if the test gives a true value, then one action is performed, otherwise the other one is performed. So if the amount that is inserted is equal to zero, it will be not accepted, and the message error will be returned, will be printed. It will not be returned because it's a void. It's a void method. So insert money zero. It will print the error message. Also for a negative value, it will print the error message. While for a positive value, it will update plan, so let's create a completely new object. And look at get balance, and it is zero. With a negative value as a parameter for inserting money, the error is printed, and the balance field is still zero. But if a valid amount is entered, the message error does not appear, and the balance field, the value of the balance field gets updated. Are there other exercises? Sure. I can have to predict this. Oh, now let's change to the greater than or equal operator in the test. And so if the amount that is entered is zero, it will not print the error message, and the balance will not get updated. Well, it will get updated because the amount, if the amount that is entered is zero, the balance, the value of the balance field will not really get updated, but yes, it stays the same. But that's the action that will be performed. Yeah, balance will get updated. Yes. So if the amount is zero, balance will get updated. So let's try. I call insert money with zero, and I don't receive any error message. And get balance is zero. It's still zero, even if I insert again zero. But it's a different zero because it's zero plus zero. Now I can rewrite the conditional statement in another way. So for the case in which the test will give true, I will print the error message. Otherwise, when the test gives a false value, the balance gets updated. So the condition for the if statement should be written with the less or equal amount less or equal to zero. I don't get any message for a positive value. I get an error message for a negative value. No. What's the other exit? Oh, okay. I should go to the figures project because there is a field for circle that has a Boolean value. Let's see if it is appropriate. Okay, Boolean is visible. Yeah, so this field can only have two possible values, true or false, so it's visible, so it is appropriate.